But for you to come, before these people and openly lie and said that this man or anybody from my camp asked for money for another committee, that's a lie. That's a bold-faced lie. And you know it.
Mayor, with all due respect, number one, at the very tail end of the campaign, you got $37,000. Number two, I didn't endorse the check you did. So with all due respect, it's like
you endorsed
the check.
Yes, I did.
You didn't send the Lansing Democratic Committee on it.
Yes, I did.
But look, the fact of the matter is, you returned the money to us. We returned the city. If the city committee wants to pay outstanding bills with it from last year with it, they want to save it for this year. If they want to give it back to us, hey, whatever. But the city committee should make a decision on what they want to do with this money and go from there. But with all due respect, you got $37,000 at the very end of October. Right?
You could have gotten a half of me.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to
get it.
As I was saying, while it may be convenient,
address
Mike,
your comments to the chair and the party, please. No Mike, direct comments back.
Excuse me, Mr.
Look, I'm at the mic. You hold your point. While it may be convenient, do I not get a chance to make a statement?
Let us make a statement.
Can I make a statement? Then I'll open it for questions.
Don't make a statement. Next person. Thank you. Please, if you have anything to say, please come my way. And we can talk.
Again, while it may be convenient, Mike, for you to be able to make that statement, because it begs the question of intent. Now, if you said that I called you and specifically asked you for a check that belonged to the committee, what you're doing is pushing off intent from your point. But let me make it absolutely clear. I never called you and asked you specifically for a check for the committee. Had I known that there was a check specifically for the committee, then I would have called Ms. Joyce and let her know. So I don't know. We're going back 4 months, and maybe you have an lapse of memory or something along that line. But I have never called you and specifically asked you for a check for the committee. Never. That's my statement.
Yes.
Any questions?
Can I respond to that?
Yes.
Yes. This is what this is what the higher
level is about. If you would be quiet.
Mike, grab the mic.
All I'm saying is, we will respectfully disagree on the phone call, but if I'm in possession of a check that's not made out to me, why am I going to say, geez, maybe I should get this to the right person? With all due respect, Mr. Winstead, why stand again? I'm not trying to put on the bus as I'm wearing the bus, but when you got the check, didn't you say, hey, I'll give it to Joyce? I mean, again, Mr. Gilliam's here, Mr. Winstead's here, but I'm not going to get blamed for something we didn't do.
There you go.
The only thing I'm going to say about this check is the check.
Somebody going to jail.
The county should have gave the check to the Atlantic City Democratic Commission. That's where the problems start. The county chair knows I've asked him for money, just like Wajito has stated. I've asked for money for the city committee for years.
Yeah.
I've told the committee people that. So the county should not have made a big mistake and given that money to anybody but the Atlantic City Democratic Committee.
It was a mistake, you said?
Excuse me.
First and foremost, I want to thank all of you for helping me get to this position. And secondly, this is a prime example of how the county tends to play the city against each other. Mind you, when the check was delivered, it was stated that they gave it to me. Then he said it wasn't given to me. Then he said it was given to Richard. Then he said he didn't even know Richard, right? Because when we became aware of the check, right? Because thousands of people came through our committee, our campaign headquarters, dropped the envelope and said, this is a contribution. That check never came with any instructions of who to give it to, because I would have immediately called Joyce or Miss Hudgens, right? So then we get a call. We immediately look at our records. The records displayed that, yes, we had basically gotten a check. And yes, I endorsed it. But I also reported it to the Board of Elections to make sure there was accountability for the money. So if I was trying to take something from someone, it would have went to my personal account or it would have went someplace else. What is problematic with this whole scenario is I asked Mr. Dict and I asked Suleiman, why would you take a check and drop it off at my place and never tell us who the check belonged to? That very same day, we deposited 8 different checks. One of the 8 happened to be the committee's check. It was an oversight, simple and plain, because an oversight on my behalf that I signed the check that was supposed to go to the committee. Now, anybody knows that if something belongs to Joyce, she... When I get checks, sometime I do, sometime I don't, because it's so many that came in. But again, I'm here to stand before you and tell you, yes, I made the oversight. There was never a point in time where I did not say I did not endorse the check, nor was a time that I say I did not report the check. And when we were basically told that at the committee, I was as shocked about the check because Suleiman nor Dick ever told us that there was a check for the committee. So when Miss Joyce finds it at the meeting that it was not a check, there was a check for the committee, she stands up and says, hey, where's our money? So Joyce knew nothing about the money. So I want to make sure that folks understand that Miss Joyce has nothing to do with this. So when I asked Suleiman, I said, man, why would you drop a check and did not call and say, hey, did Miss Joyce get her money? Why did you not call Miss Hudgens and say, Miss Hudgens, did the money come through?
You're supposed to believe this.
Oh, you can believe it or not. You can believe it or not, but all due respect, if I was trying to steal, why would I report the money to your elect?
Well, who brought the money, the check to the campaign?
Mr. Dick brought the check to the campaign, nor did he basically give it to me, nor did he give it to Richard. It was delivered in an envelope, right? With no instructions. He's never said, hey, this check is for the committee. A plain envelope, right? Yes. Yes. I just told you it was an oversight. So when a check, when any check has came to my committee or campaign, I never questioned it who it's supposed to be because a check's coming to me, and that's how thousands of checks. So that's how thousands of checks came. But if it would have came with directions, it would have been simple to say, okay, Joyce, I have a $10,000 check here for you. Come get it. But because it came with no instructions.
It came with instructions. The Democratic Committee on it. That's the instructions. Oh, okay. My bad. I thought it was open floor. My bad.
It had Democratic Committee check. I mean, on it, right?
Won't do
it
again.
I'm telling you that when I got checks, I flip it over and I sign it. No matter what's on it.
Yeah, you don't look at it. You just sign checks.
When I'm basically getting hundreds and thousands of checks, yes.
You don't look at who you're giving the money to.
No. I look at who I'm giving the money. If the money does not come with instructions to go someplace else, I'm automatically endorsing it and putting it in the pile. No, I did not see that.
You just signed.
Yes, I just signed it, right? But when I found out, again, if it was ill intent, I would not have signed it and then had it reported to elect. That's just like me robbing a bank and going to the cops and saying, hey, I just robbed the bank. But the point is, for the county, right, to sit here and lie and say that he had a conversation with me or Rich about asking money, we called him and asked him for the money that was deserving of us. I would never have called
the county and ask for the committee's money? Who does that? Why would I call the county and ask for the Atlantic City's committee's money and then deposit it and then end up reporting? I did not see the name on the check. That's my point.
So the county treasurer and the county chair started mumbling about it. And they said that it was sent. And then they said it wasn't. Then they said it was sent to the mayor, Mayor Gilley. With the county, it was said that it was given to Richard Winston, campaign manager for the mayor for Gilley's campaign, and presented the question about the check. The next day, I spoke with the mayor, and he explained it was a mistake. I spoke again with the county during the county fundraiser, county cheer. He stated everything was taken care of.
In the same boat, and I can tell you again, again, in hindsight, should have given the check directly to Ms. Mullen or Ms. Hudgens? Absolutely. However, why the check was deposited in another account, that I don't know. Why the bank accepted, I don't know. That's questions.
I'm not asking about the check being deposited because we're not even at that part yet. I'm asking you why you never called her to say, did you get the money, Joyce?
Well, and look, you know, perhaps I should have. All I'm saying is Richard, myself,
because
Joyce,
she never called and thanked you. Because if somebody's giving me $10,000, I'm going to call them and say, thanks for that money. So if it's that she never called to thank you, you should have called her. Because I would have been feeling some type of way if it was me. I just gave her $10,000. She ain't called me and said thank you. Joyce, you ain't even call and say thanks for the money. What's going on?
Because she talks about it all the time.
Because she talks about it all the time. How the county never gives us money. How we never have money. She talks about it to you guys. She talks about it to us. It's a broken record. And we're feeling all that. Because we never get no money through there. So again, she never called you. The treasurer, somebody should have called and checked to make sure it was. And we trust but verify. We trust but we verify.
Well, look, now we know in the future to do that, but again, no one thought that a check now to the Atlantic City Democratic Committee would somehow end up in an account that's a completely different name. And again, we were victims in this too. We had no idea until 3 months later that this check was deposited in another account.
And they cash it too. They have it from October to January.
So if we didn't check the check image, we would have no idea.
See, any more questions for Mike?
Thanks, Mike.
Any more questions? He has a question over here.
When you write a check for $10,000 for somebody in October, that they're supposed to use it for whatever reason in November, the committee decides, the Atlantic City Committee decides where that check will go be used. So if that check did not get used for what purpose that was made for, and after 3-4 months we realize, oh, what happened here? So we go back. So it didn't serve the purpose of what it was supposed to do. Now we're returning the check to Joyce. I want to thank Joyce for bringing it out first, because she's the one actually saw that and brought it up. And I want to thank her for doing that. I mean, it took some time, which it shouldn't. But, you know, you guys should have asked. If Democrat committee was written a check in October to use it for November election, and nothing was done, and the committee, people didn't even know, and we didn't know, it's written to the committee, I'm a committee person. We had the choice to decide where that check was gonna go. So if we didn't get that opportunity, so it didn't serve its purpose. Now it comes back, which is good, but it didn't serve the purpose, it didn't do good, it's not gonna do any good, because that time that it was made for is already passed.
George.
I don't know how that works. The bank, how they did it.
I don't know how the banks work either.
But
again, you would.
I request to find out through the bank how they allow something like this.
Democrats, that you can't say about Republicans, we're transparent today. That means everybody see and get to speak of what happened with this committee as well as the county. And we must continue to be transparent, because we talk about people's vote and people's monies that donated to campaigns. So it's very important that everybody understand this. all those critics out there that the Democrats are united and they're transparent. And we're working on being united a little bit more.